The future of transportation is not flying cars, as much as we'd want it to be. It's actually self-driving. But with Tesla and Waymo battling it out like it's Mario Kart on Autopilot, things are about to get crazy. With complex algorithms and cutting-edge technology, the question remains, who will conquer the AI throne and usher in the era of autonomous vehicles? Hello and welcome back to Future Tech Tea Room, where we bring the latest and greatest news from the AI world. So, you're stuck in a rush hour, inching forward like a snail dipped in molasses. Suddenly, a futuristic pod zooms past, its sleek design radiating confidence. Inside, you see a relaxed passenger, phone in hand, oblivious to the traffic woes. This, my friends, is a glimpse into the future of transportation, the realm of self-driving cars. But how exactly does this magic work? Self-driving technology is like a super-powered co-pilot. It uses a combination of cameras, radar, and laser sensors to perceive its surroundings, just like human eyes. Then, powerful computers analyze this data in real time, making decisions like steering, braking, and acceleration, all without a single touch of the wheel. Now, in the race for self-driving supremacy, two companies have emerged as frontrunners. First, there's Tesla, the electric car maverick, led by the visionary Elon Musk. Tesla takes a camera-based approach, focusing on training its AI to see the world and react accordingly. On the other side of the ring, we have Waymo, the self-driving car project spun out of Google. Waymo utilizes detailed high-definition maps alongside its sensors, creating a kind of virtual roadmap for its vehicles. So, who will reign supreme in the age of autonomous cars? Tesla, the bold innovator, or Waymo, the methodical cartographer? It turns out teaching a car to drive is way harder than we thought. Humans are surprisingly good at it, not just handling the car, but anticipating what other drivers might do. Remember that crazy guy who cuts you off every morning? To reach that level of understanding, self-driving cars need a massive amount of data, and two companies are leading the pack, Tesla and Waymo. Think of Tesla like a student cramming for a test by studying with hundreds of thousands of classmates. These classmates are Tesla owners, driving their cars all over the world, many using Autopilot, Tesla's current assist while you drive system. As these cars navigate the roads, Tesla collects data on how Autopilot performs and how it might perform if you weren't paying close attention. It's a strategy straight out of Elon Musk's playbook. Remember how SpaceX tested rockets on real launches? So what is the advantage? Sheer volume. Tesla doesn't reveal exact figures, but estimates suggest they've collected billions of miles of data. And with every new Tesla sold, that number grows exponentially. It's not perfect, though. Autopilot isn't fully autonomous, and Tesla can only learn from situations where it's actually engaged. But here's the clever bit. Tesla cars can even log instances where Autopilot could have taken action even when it wasn't on. The shadow mode lets them simulate full Autopilot data across those billions of miles driven. Waymo, on the other hand, is like the student who meticulously studies textbooks and builds elaborate models. They use powerful computers to simulate billions of miles of driving, creating virtual worlds for their self-driving cars to navigate. They also have a real-world fleet, but much smaller than Tesla's. Around 500 self-driving minivans, currently roaming the streets of California, Texas, and a few other states. Waymo simulations are impressive, but the real world throws curveballs computers can't always predict. That's where Tesla's real-world miles become an advantage, argues analyst Tasha Keeney. Tesla might not have the most advanced technology right now, but their massive data set could be a game changer. The competition is fierce, and both companies are ramping up. Waymo plans to add thousands of new minivans to its fleet and is partnering with Jaguar Land Rover to develop a fully self-driving SUV. Tesla, for its part, keeps selling more cars, adding to their ever-growing data pool. So, who will win the self-driving race? Let's put the two titans in the ring and find out. We've seen how Tesla and Waymo collect data at different scales. But their real plot twist is what kind of data they collect. It's like they're speaking different languages. Waymo's self-driving minivans are decked out like tech-geared superheroes. They have a whole arsenal of sensors, LiDAR, radar, and cameras, all working together to paint a detailed picture of the world around them. LiDAR is the star player on Waymo's team. Imagine a super-powered flashlight that shoots millions of laser beams per second. By measuring how long it takes those beams to bounce back, LiDAR creates a super high-resolution 3D map of the car's surroundings, even in the dark. Pretty impressive, right? Tesla, on the other hand, takes a different approach. They ditch the LiDAR and rely heavily on cameras, like super-powered eyes for the car. It's a risky strategy, according to some experts. They argue that cameras struggle in low-light conditions, and without LiDAR's detailed 3D map, Tesla's cars might be at a disadvantage. Elon Musk, however, sees LiDAR as an expensive crutch. He believes Tesla can train its cars to see the world well enough with cameras alone, which would be a major cost advantage. If Tesla pulls this off, it could be a game changer for the industry. But here's the thing. We don't even know exactly what data Tesla is collecting. Their privacy policy is a bit vague. They mention collecting information on speed, braking, and battery usage, but when it comes to autopilot data, it's all about information regarding the use and operation of the feature. Not exactly clear, is it? The lack of transparency makes some experts skeptical. They question if Tesla's camera-only approach, combined with potentially limited data collection, can truly lead to fully driverless cars. Right now, Waymo's LiDAR-powered data sets seem to be more detailed, but Tesla's camera-first approach, if successful, could be a major breakthrough. So, Tesla and Waymo are stockpiling data, but collecting it is just half the battle. The real challenge? Turning all those numbers into usable knowledge for their self-driving cars. Even Elon Musk admits it's a tough nut to crack. Imagine trying to teach a car to drive by feeding it a fire hose of information. There's just so much data to process and learn from. Waymo, on the other hand, seems pretty chill about processing all that data. They've built elaborate computer simulations of entire cities. Think of it as a giant virtual racetrack where they can unleash thousands of self-driving cars to practice in perfect safety. This allows them to test countless scenarios, like a million variations of that tricky left turn you always dread. The learnings from these simulations are then fed back to their real-world cars, creating a tight feedback loop. The closed-loop approach gives Waymo a lot of control, but it comes at a price. They've invested a ton of resources, time, money, and brain power to build these elaborate simulations. According to field experts, it's unlikely Tesla can compete at this level. Replicating Waymo's setup would be incredibly expensive and labor-intensive for Tesla. Remember that 6 billion mile benchmark Musk mentioned for achieving self-driving car approval? Tesla has likely surpassed that mark in real-world driving, yet their cars still aren't quite there. That promised self-driving LA to New York demo? Delayed. The rollout of their ultimate autopilot version? That target keeps moving. Meanwhile, Waymo is nearing that 6 billion mile mark in simulations, and their virtual fleet is growing rapidly. They're even launching a self-driving ride-hailing service later this year, which will generate even more valuable data. So who's winning the data processing game? Well, again, it's a close call. Waymo has the controlled environment and tight feedback loop of their simulations. Tesla has the sheer volume of real-world data, but processing it efficiently remains a hurdle. Whoever cracks the code on turning data into knowledge will take the crown. So, we've explored the data strategies, processing power, and the approach of both companies in the self-driving car race. But who's in the lead? Well, declaring a winner is tricky. Tesla has a massive lead in real-world miles driven by its autopilot customers. That's a ton of data, and if they can crack the code on using cameras alone without LiDAR, they could theoretically update their cars overnight and become the first to market with fully self-driving vehicles. But here's the hitch: proving safety. With just a small test fleet and ongoing investigations into autopilot accidents, Tesla faces an uphill battle on the safety front. Waymo, on the other hand, might have the edge in safety. Their self-driving minivans are racking up miles in controlled environments, and with a larger future fleet, they could build a stronger safety case. However, expanding their testing will take time, and regulations are still being ironed out. Even defining safety is a challenge. Right now, disengagement, when a human driver has to take control, is a common metric, but it's unreliable. Ultimately, self-driving cars will need to be proven as safe or safer than human drivers. How we measure that safety, accidents, injuries, deaths per mile, is another hurdle. We believe that conclusive safety evidence might be hard to come by until self-driving cars are widely used. It's a bit of a chicken and egg situation. We can't prove they're safe until they're on the road, but regulators won't let them on the road without proof of safety. The answer? Well, it's too early to say. Tesla has the data advantage, but struggles with safety. Waymo might be safer, but their deployment is slower. The most likely winner will be the company that can crack the data processing challenge, prove safety to regulators, and navigate the complex world of self-driving car regulations. This is a marathon, not a sprint. And the finish line? Well, it's still a long way off. Who'd you pick as the winner? Which self-driving car would you want to be driven in? Make sure to leave your answers in the comment section below. And that's it for this video. If you enjoyed watching this, please make sure to drop us a like. Your support is like rocket fuel for this channel. If you hit that subscribe button and smash that notification bell, you'll be the first to know when we launch into the next chapter of this AI saga. Plus, the more you watch, the more awesome tech stories we can bring you. So join us on this incredible journey. See you next time, friends!